Hi, I'm Tom Lovstedt. I'm from Sweden. And the home, it is about 0 degrees and raining, sometimes snowing, sometimes raining. And it's just wonderful to be here in Miami and Coral Reef. You have summer, which is better than the summer in Sweden already now. It's just so nice to be here. It's perfect weather and nice sailing, a lot of competition, and you enjoy yourself really being here. It's postponement now, and we are waiting that the wind will veer about 180 degrees, so we'll just have to wait and see. But that's pretty normal in sailing, it's some waiting always.
Well, I'm Mark Reynolds, and I've been coming here since 1983, so it's been a few years.
And I'm Brad Funk, and yeah, just came here to sail the Star and check out the scene, and yeah, having fun.
Well, I kind of don't know anything else because I grew up sailing a Star. My father was a Star sailor and world champion, and it's a pretty technical boat in a lot of ways, but we were just talking about it. It's a very tactical boat as well, and if you just sail the boat tactically, you're going to do well in the races, and Brad showed that yesterday by being in the top 10, top 5.
Yeah, I mean, it was a bit of plug and play for me. I was pretty much given a really good boat and good sails and a really good crew, Mark Strube, and just went out and just sailed like you'd normally sail in the bay here. So it was pretty easy for me.
The Bacardi Cup draws, you know, the top sailors internationally, a lot like a World Championships does, but it's also a little bit more of a laid-back, fun regatta with only one race a day. You know, we have some time in the morning and in the afternoon to hang out with friends, and we have some nice Bacardi parties in the evening.
Jennings, and I sail with Brian Sharp, my crew. And we've been sailing stars now together for probably about 5 years. And I've been working the last 2 years with this boat, it's P-Star. And actually going pretty well, we ended up winning today's race. So we started right at the pin end, and had a nice left shift that let us tack shortly after the start. And then it was just a long port tack. We hung in there, rounded right behind Mark Reynolds, sailed downwind with him. He actually got a penalty for rocking, I think. And that sprung us a little bit from the rest of the fleet, and then we were able to just sail in the lead from then on out. It was pretty good. Sailing the Star is probably the best sailing out there, tactically and physically. You're sailing against some of the best guys in the world. And yeah, it's just kind of one of the ultimate challenges in sailing, so it's great. This is kind of the grand finale of the Miami sailing for the Star, so you know, it's kind of a not to miss event, really.